the first thing I had that you could consider a job came when I was, I think, 11 years old. There was a dude around the block that had been paying my brother to mow his lawn for a couple years. And when he got a real job, that $10 a week lawn gig fell to me. So I'm out back mowing his lawn one day and he's not home. I'm by myself. I'm in the yard with this privacy fence all around me and a kind of creepy camper full of junk in the back. I've already mowed the lawn and I'm going over the edges with a weed eater. And I guess I leaned against something or hit something because something tall and bulbous fell in the camper, falls against the window. And it was just the right color and shape that out of the corner of my eye, it looked kind of like one of those aliens that Unsolved Mysteries warned me about, the grays, right? Now, unfortunately, I can't tell you exactly what it really was because it scared the shit out of me thoroughly enough that I just dropped the fucking weed eater and ran. I mean, luckily, it was one of those models that has a safety trigger where it turns off if you let it go. But if it didn't, I'd have left that motherfucker running because as dumb as it sounds in retrospect, I was absolutely terrified of being abducted by aliens when I was a kid. Now, this is probably something hard to sympathize with if you didn't grow up kind of exactly when I did. Because if you were just a little bit older, you were old enough to recognize the myriad alien abduction documentaries for the bullshit that they were. And if you were a little bit younger, you probably grew up after they stopped playing those all the fucking time. But when I was 10, 11 years old or so, virtually every network would throw up the occasional special wherein they would credulously present the stories of bumpkins recounting all the various things the aliens inserted into their rectums. And I was convinced that this was fact. Right, my parents told me it was all nonsense, but given all the crap they'd told me about God, I knew I couldn't trust them. I figured they'd either been duped or they were lying to comfort me. So their reassurances did nothing whatsoever to calm me. And I gotta say, my efforts to research alien abduction at the local library served only to exacerbate my terror. I got to thinking about all of this last night when I had a rare brush with that same childlike terror. So like the house and the yard and everything is all decked up for Halloween, of course. And among the decorations that my wife put up this year is this little skeleton mummy dude that hangs out of the tree and he's got a motion sensor. And when you get real close, he rocks back and forth and he screams and stuff. And somehow I managed to forget he was there. So I'm taking the trash out. Just finished working. It's almost 1 a.m. I'm wheeling this big ass trash can around front. And all of a sudden his eyes light up. This plastic cocoon starts grunting and writhing. And I drop the goddamn trash can and bolt. Right. So a few seconds later, I'm on the porch laughing at myself and being thankful it happened too late for my neighbors to have seen that. But for a fleeting moment, I remembered exactly what it felt like to be utterly terrified. I remembered what it was like for that fucking alien to show up in the dude's window. And you know what? It was almost a novel feeling. I mean, I'm not going to say I'm not afraid of shit now. I have an interest in astronomy, so I know about things way more terrifying than tree mummies and extraterrestrial anal beads. But when it's dark outside and you see a weird shape in the shadows, you never mistake it for a gamma ray burst, right? When you're alone in your house in the middle of the night and you hear a creepy sound, you never wonder whether it's a massive asteroid impact. So folks like you and I can look back at that kind of terror and largely relegate it to our childhoods. But as we're all too aware, not everybody outgrew their fears of ghosts and aliens. And I can't imagine what it must be like to live in their world. Right? I fear shit, but I fear shit that I can understand and by and large mitigate. Right? Like I'm afraid of getting into an accident on the highway. So I check my tire pressure before I get on the highway and pay attention to all them idiots that they keep letting use my roads. But what do you get out of fearing something that doesn't exist? Right? You can't learn about it because there's nothing to know and you can't ameliorate it because the likelihood was already zero. So it's a fear that exists for the sole purpose of being afraid of it. And of course, many worldviews depend on this kind of shit. In fact, all of the ones this show is dedicated to dismantling do. It's really the only thing you get for your money when you embrace an irrational worldview. You get invincible fears. That's it. Sure, they'll promise you other shit. You know, Christians will promise you salvation. Muslims will promise you eternal paradise. Natural green mommy will promise you magical anti-cancer potions, but they can't actually provide any of that. None of it exists, but the fear does. And whether you're afraid of sin, demons, or bread ingredients used in yoga mats, no application of rationality can assuage any irrational fear. And the people selling you the worldview aren't going to do it either because the fear is the fucking point. Right? People go back to church because they're afraid of hell. They go back to naturalgreenmommy.com because they're afraid of artificial flavors. They go back to their spiritual advisor because they're afraid of malignant spirits. And that is the only salvation that atheism has to offer. Right? We can't save your soul because you don't have one, but we can save you from irrational fear. Right? We can offer up a world where there are no demons. There are no words you can recite in a mirror to summon fucking ghosts. And while there might be spacefaring aliens, they're definitely not in the camper in the backyard that you're mowing. Now, there's a trade-off, right? Reality's version of death is a lot scarier than the ones that the liars have to offer. But it turns out that religious people still have to fear that shit, too. Because as anyone who's ever been told both that they're ugly and that they're beautiful knows, the lies you don't want to believe have a lot more staying power.